All right, it's time for dinner.
It took me some time, but at last, dinner is ready. Nathaniel's kitchen didn't include ready-made curry powder or garam masala, but there were plenty of other spices that could be mixed together. I think that's more interesting anyway. Cooking is a bit like chemistry, except you're not supposed to make things explode.
Well,
I hated chemistry. Good chutney is beyond me, though, even if the right ingredients had been here, so that limits what dishes I can present well. My father would say that a good dinner party should have many different dishes available so that the guests can try a little of everything until they find something they like.
I say that's a good idea in case someone doesn't like something, like me. Have something very plain and unspicy.
If you serve only one dish and someone doesn't like it, it's a problem.
Oh, snap.
Of course, if my father were holding a dinner party, he'd just have it catered, and then it's easy to have a wide selection. Both of my parents can cook, but if they had guests to impress, they'd be too busy with other things than the food.
Oh, I see.
Anyway, what I've ended up with is spiced potatoes, vegetable biryani, and sweet fried bread. Nothing too... I don't know what that word is.
Ultra. Is it done yet? I'm starved.
Yes, come on in. The boys begin to filter in and take their seats.
They look very eager, even Albin.
Linz tilts his head curiously, drawing in a long, slow breath of air through his nose and holding it for a few minutes before exhaling.
Uh-oh.
All right. He doesn't say anything more.
Thank you very much for preparing all this food for us.
Wait until you eat it before you say that. I know I'm not a bad cook, but I don't know what they like either. Anyway, help yourselves. There should be enough. I dish some onto my own plate without waiting for anyone else. I'm hungry. The others follow suit, a little more cautiously in some cases.
Is there any meat in this?
No, it won't hurt you to eat some vegetables. Unless someone has allergies that they didn't tell me about.
Vegetables are a side dish.
I'm not forcing you to convert.
I'm sure it will be fine.
The meal progresses quietly for a bit as everyone samples the food. Despite what he said earlier, I'm not sure Nathaniel is enjoying the meal. He doesn't seem to be eating very much.
Should have told us then.
But then, I haven't been closely watching how he eats before. Maybe I'm just paranoid.
Maybe you should just eat by yourself and stop watching everyone.
Linz isn't eating very much either, and chews each bite with slow deliberation. He's probably distracted.
I usually eat slowly if I don't like it. This is great!
Don't talk with your mouth full. He just grins at me. Wait, he likes it? So, how's the procedure going?
What?
The thing with the force field to overload it.
Yes, that.
He sets his fork on his plate.
Everything is proceeding according to schedule. The stored charge continues to increase.
It's hard to imagine needing so much power that it would take days to build up the charge. Short circuits burn out very quickly.
It's got a nuclear reactor down in the basement. They also have a distinct tendency to explode, which might be entertaining to watch from outside the house. Even for you, that would be an expensive disaster. Certainly, I am myself irreplaceable.
At least until you find a way to copy yourself.
Can you do that in this universe?
He said until you find a way. Not yet.
And thank goodness for that.
There can only be one. I know it's too soon for you to know, but if you do end up remaining here, do you have any idea of what you want to do with your future?
Well, I was thinking about becoming a doctor, but I don't know. I have an awful lot to learn about how things work here.
You might be able to discover future advances that you already know about.
Isn't that cheating?
Would you rather keep the information secret and let lives be lost needlessly?
No, of course not. I can see it now. Dr. Bhaskar charges to the rescue, heroically performing unknown procedures on dying patients over the protests of her shocked co-workers because there's no time to explain when lives are at stake. My parents would be so proud. Except that they would never know.
In their hearts, they would know.
It's kind of you to say that. In their hearts, they'd probably believe I was murdered. They surely wouldn't believe I'd run away, not after last year. I've been making the best of things. I haven't given up.
Yeah, I'm sure they wouldn't somehow know in their hearts that you were alive in another universe saving people's lives. That's just a little bizarre.
And if I had just run off, I'm not sure they'd be happy to see me back.
Really? They probably would. I think you're being a little harsher on your parents. Usually they're happy even if they don't say it. Hey, Janet, is there any dessert?
I didn't make any, but there's still plenty of ice cream in the freezer.
That'll do.
Well, at least one person thinks my dinner was a success.
The countdown continues.
After dinner, I find a comfortable place to curl up with a book. Because this is a different world, every book here is something I've never read before. Combined with the size of Nathaniel's library, I could be busy here for ages. But in the long run, I know I'll start to miss my old favorites, the authors I can rely on, and the books I read over again.
Hmm. Hey, Janet.
Hi.
Thanks for making dinner. It was really nice of you.
You're welcome.
See, I thought I should do something nice for you, in exchange. But it's hard to think of what I can do while we're stuck in here.
That's okay, you don't have to.
So do you want a back rub?
Well... Huh?
I'm pretty good at them. It's all I could come up with.
Well, okay.
This is gonna be awkward. He's probably never done this before and it's just gonna hurt.
Barley gets into place behind me and rests his hands on my shoulders. He has such big, strong hands.
Oh my.
His thumbs start to work their way into my back and... Oh. He's right. He is good at this.
Oh, he's had some experience, huh? I'm not hurting you, am I?
No, it feels great. This is so awkward to read.
I'm not reading this. I'm not reading this. You can read this for yourselves. This is just too perverted.
Is Alvin outside the door listening again?
Stop going at it, you two. I'm going to go deeper. Let me know if I'm doing it too hard.
Mmm.
Ryu. Oh.
Ew.
Claire.
I think I needed this. I'm not very good at relaxing on my own.
We need to go deeper.
Where did you learn to do this?
Youth group, mostly.
That sounds really scary.
Oh, my.
Do you normally do this to, your dates?
What? No, I mean... Well, you know.
I know what?
You know what I was doing with all those girls.
All their nights out were as boring as mine?
Was it that bad?
Not bad, just not good either.
Oh, that's harsh.
But you never went further with anybody?
Well, a couple of ladies got pushy, but nothing more than a kiss. They got pushy? Aren't you gonna kiss me, damn it?
He lets go of my shoulders.
I demand a kiss before this night is through. I couldn't get involved with anybody. If I had a real girlfriend, I'd have to give up on searching, unless
Why?
She just went out to the same place every night.
Yeah, and held her hand. Like, what? If you'd had a real girlfriend, you could have told her the truth, and she could have gone with you on your search every week.
Oh, damn it, I didn't think of that. What girl would believe my story?
A girl like me.
Besides, I don't know if this magic would have worked with just any girl. Maybe I needed you.
There's nothing special about me.
Sure there is. And, there's something you should know.
Uh-oh. What is it?
The car didn't really break down.
Didn't we know this? I know.
Yeah. You know?
I can put two and two together.
It equals five, dammit.
You've been looking for that mysterious house every trip. You knew where it was supposed to be, and you knew that normally there was nothing there. Finding that house was your whole purpose. You weren't going to let anything get in your way.
Let me just keep on driving by.
As soon as I said I saw lights in the woods in the right place, you killed the car and made it so that we needed to investigate.
Killed the car? Just turned it off, I think.
He killed it.
He murdered that car. Frickin' murdered it, man. So, you're not mad?
I understand why you did it, but I don't think it was right.
Did she understand it at the time?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
You spent so much effort searching, but I don't think you made enough plans for what to do when you found something. What if they had been murderers? What would have happened to me? And now that we've disappeared, just like Susan did, will anyone know where to look for us? Did you leave any clues?
No. I guess I'm just dumb.
Yes. You're not dumb. You wouldn't have found your way here at all if you were.
It was just dumb luck, though.
I think you're dumb.
It's not like he did anything that was particularly important. He just knew enough to... He brute forced it. He just kept on going out every night with a girl.
Yeah.
It's not exactly an intelligent solution. I spent so long on my game plan to follow Susan, but now I'm past all the goals I planned for. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I'm out of ideas. I'm not smart enough.
You just need help with the planning. That's what partners are for.
Okay, partner. What should we do now?
I feel like partner should have been written with a D. Partner.
Partner.
There's a good question. I'd really like to know what Linz is up to in the basement, but we promised Nathaniel we wouldn't interrupt him. From the questions he asked us earlier, Linz has some knowledge of many different fields of science. He could be doing anything down there. I hope I'll get to find out when he's done. Well, Linz said he'd help us when he's finished here, but I think he's more interested in finding a wormhole than in finding Susan.
Yeah, no doubt.
So we should come up with ideas for that. It won't be easy since she could be anywhere by now, and we don't know the best ways to search in this world. We should probably talk to a private detective, although it would be expensive to hire one. Also, there are little things we can do ourselves, like checking phone books or reading old newspapers for stories about finding a missing girl, a mystery girl. Or making posters to hang up around town. Do you have a picture of her?
An old one in my wallet.
We can have that photocopied, and the poster can mention your name, and maybe some details from our world that she would recognize. It's a long shot, but it's a start.
We might get lucky. Thanks. I'm glad you're here. Nice. He's glad we're here.
Darkness like velvet surrounds me, warm and soft, blacker than the blackest night.
Uh-oh.
But somewhere in that void, there's a guiding star.
I see it.
It's the only thing that I can see, my only point of reference, and so of course I walk towards it.
Fly towards the star.
The light is the way out. Home, my family, my future. It's all waiting for me in the light.
Either that or to an atomic blast.
But wait, isn't that what they say about heaven? I don't want to go to heaven. Not yet. I don't want to die.
Getting a bit dramatic here.
I turn to walk away from the light, but the darkness behind me has become solid.
Wait, if the light's heaven, is the darkness hell? Because I'm not sure that's an acceptable alternative.
I punch and kick at the solid wall of black behind me, and only succeed in pushing myself towards the light.
Nice job, hero.
I don't want to walk into the light. If I can't go back, at least I can stand still until I work out what's going on here. And then the ground under my feet begins to slope. What was that?
Bam! That was interesting.
I don't know what I was dreaming, but I heard a noise. Somehow that woke me up. I just can't quite remember what that noise was.
An explosion?
There's no one here but me. I wait for a moment, but I don't hear anyone at the door either. Something feels wrong. It's too quiet. Quiet couldn't wake me up. It's like there was an explosion?
That's what it sounded like to me.
I need to find someone who can help.
Anyone.
And the person I trust most in this place is just down the hall. Psst! Bradley, wake up!
Bradley probably can't do anything about it, though.
No. I tap on his door, trying not to wake the rest of the house.
Like, it's probably related to Linz's experiment, Mermble.
Whoa. Is very frightening right now.
He's not wearing anything, is he? I can see his little creases down there.
A bleary-looking figure opens the door.
This is one of those situations where you don't want to press the middle mouse button.
No.
Janet, what was...
I was going to say something, but the thought is briefly knocked out of my head by the sight of Bradley's tanned? Muscular and entirely naked body, he does not look tan.
What is it?
He notices me staring and looks down.
Ugh!
He steps back into his room and closes the door.
Just gonna slide away there. Let me get dressed first.
I hear some rustling and thumps as he moves about.
The lights won't turn on. Uh-oh.
I heard an explosion or something. It woke me up. That's why I came looking for you.
Well, so much for the uptime. Give me a minute. I've got my shirt.
Oh, if the power's out, that means the overload happened and the force fields should be down. He steps out of the room again, pulling his jacket on.
Let's go take a look.
We tiptoe down the stairs, eager to see, but still trying to keep quiet.
That means we could sneak out, but is someone going to see us?
Beyond the front door, a shimmering, twisting field of light remains.
Whoa, looks even weirder than before now.
Yeah, it does. You can't even see through. I don't understand. How can that still be there if there's no power?
Maybe it's weakened, or maybe they weren't telling us the truth.
Before I can stop him, he reaches out to touch the force field. His hand goes right through it.
What?
What?
It's working. We can leave. Come on, Janet. Let's go see this new world of theirs.
He takes my hand and is suddenly flung backwards.
What is going on in here? What?
I let go of his hand and poke the force field. It's just as solid as ever. Too late. It came back.
That can't be right.
He aims a punch at the force field and his fist passes through with no resistance.
But you...
Repeated tests confirm it. Bradley can reach through the force field, but I can't, and neither can he if he's touching me.
I don't understand.
Every time we think this house makes sense, it turns out that it doesn't. Could Linz and Nathaniel and the others have been lying to us all along? Does this force field affect anyone other than me? Maybe you should go out and look for help.
We can't go out.
I can't. You can.
What about you?
I'd wait here for you. Bradley looks at the force field.
If I went out there, I might not be able to get back in.
If it doesn't affect you...
I only got here in the first place because I was holding on to you.
That's right. He believed at first that whatever made people disappear only took girls, one at a time, and that he had to keep hold of me in order to find out where they went. But that was before we knew that this was a different universe and a different time. If the car went through a wormhole, it shouldn't have mattered if Bradley was holding my hand afterwards or not, because we'd already been on the other side. Something here doesn't add up.
What is going on? There's something very wrong in this house. From the very beginning, they've been nice to you, but not me. You pulled a gun on
them. Yeah, come on, Bradley.
They don't want me here.
Well, you did pull a gun on them.
And now they have that too. They could be planning to do anything to you. This field thing blocks you, but not me. You're trapped here, but not me. If I went outside without you, I might never see you again. And I won't leave you behind.
Bradley. It's sweet of him to worry about me, but...
But should Janet insist that Bradley leave the mansion on his own?
Ugh.
Oh, what a decision. Well, what are your thoughts so far?
I feel like him leaving gives us the best chance, doesn't it?
I don't know, does it?
I don't know. Maybe not.
So which way? Should it be yes or no?
I don't know.
He doesn't want to leave us behind. We know that much.
Yeah. So maybe if he doesn't want to, we shouldn't force him?
All right. So since Bradley wants to stay, I guess we'll agree with him. Because, you know, we can't make him leave, can we?
Maybe there's a way to turn the force field off so we can both leave.
Losing power was supposed to do that.
Yes, but Linz has been up to something from the beginning, and they've been trying to hide it from us. Maybe the key to all this is in the basement.
It's worth a try.
Cautious of every shadow, we make our way to the basement stairs. Down and around and down, until... An alarm starts ringing in our ears!
Of course, the alarm still works. Where did that come from?
Should we go back?
It's too late now. We may as well find out the truth.
But at the bottom of the stairs, we find only a firmly locked door.
Damn it.
He rattles at the door a bit.
Can you pick locks?
I can try, but I've never actually managed to do it. I don't have much work with, though. I don't even have a hairpin. Do you have any safety pins?
No. Maybe we should just break it down. I think that's enough of that.
Caught.
So your true colors are revealed. Oh no.
Bradley opens his mouth to speak, but I flick the side of his leg with a fingernail to distract him. What true colors? We heard an explosion and came down to see if everything was okay.
An explosion?
The power's out upstairs, haven't you noticed? Wait a second, he actually looks worried. What's going on here? Rapid footsteps echo down the stairs. How could I be the only one who heard the explosion?
You! There's no time. Get these two out of here. I have to see to the lab and hope it's not too late. Alright, exactly what has happened in that basement, and what is going on? Well, maybe we'll find out now on this Tuesday morning. Until then, take care, everyone.
Bye.